So in the end, yeah, it's all about efficiency. I mean, like, look at all of those goods we're transferring here. Hi guys, it's Neodyinamite and welcome back to Factory Town. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I did a little bit of changes as you can see on the screen. And I am very happy with those changes because this is the moment when Factory Town actually shines. Ladies and gentlemen, I have automated the process of making food. So basically, you remember we used to have a kitchen over here. That later on was transporting, I think, bread by a cart to the market thingy. Now everything's made with conveyor belts, everything is automated. So let's actually start from the farms, shall we? I've built the farms on the hill, as for example this one over here. This farm makes grain, it has full access to water and to fertilizers as well. Even the water is automated. Like normally I need to have like a worker here who's carrying the water from the well to the farm. Now, because of a conveyor belt and a very fancy tool called the grabber actually grabs the water from the well and puts it inside of the farm. So the farm now has full supplies, it creates grain. Later on, this grain is getting rolled down over here, as you can see, similar to those two farms over here. Conveyor belt goes here with fertilizers. It goes into the barn. It's then like calculated, whatever, and then separated and sent to two additional grain mills over here. Also by those sliders thingies over here. Those grain mills are responsible for making flour and animal feed. The animal feed is later on deployed by grabber once again into this conveyor belt and move it around here into those two pastures. One of them is making beef, the other one is making beef and rough chicken. So those two materials are then moved by this conveyor belt under here next to the road along with the flour to the kitchen, but also the animal feed is moved up here by this conveyor belt and goes back to the farm. So this is all automated. Similar idea over here. It's beautiful. It's really beautiful. So the kitchen receives the flour, the beef and rough chicken. Also uses the coal from this coal deposit over here, and then by conveyor belt everything that's made by the kitchen is transported into the food market over here, and the people received food and they are so happy. So ladies and gentlemen, I had to make actually conveyor belts. The conveyor belts need to be done in the workshop, so this, like, let's say construction working plant, whatever thing, right at the moment is responsible only for making new conveyor belts. Later on we're gonna of course change this thing. This is all work in progress. But I was busy with different things because I've ordered my school to do a little bit of research, and ladies and gentlemen, now we have finally access to mining. We used to have. Wait, why the hell does this thing is blocked? Wait, I didn't get mining? Hold on a second. Oh, I did not mining? This is a separated thing? Or did I loaded the wrong save game? No, I have to do this thing. I thought I have unlocked it. Oh my god, I made a goof. Whoops. So this is gonna be a while, because now we have to actually wait for the mining to get finished by the research thingy. So yeah, that's gonna be the thing. No worries, we can actually focus on different things. As I was unlocking new terrain to build, I found myself a fire temple over here. So later on we can try to use the fire temple to make ourselves the fire crystals. I'm not sure exactly what this thing is for. This is for the magic department, and I don't have access currently to that thing. The idea is that I want to get rid of the iron deposits here, and later on I can try to move the conveyor belt a little bit closer so we can actually decorate this thing a little bit better, because right now the fire temple is stuck between coal deposits and trees, and that's like not very nice. Oh, we have cotton over here. Huh. Maybe we could try to use the cotton for something. If I remember correctly, I think the farms have access to cotton recipe, right? Let's see. You have access to sugar? Yeah, you have cotton. Okay. Hmm. Alright, I think we could try to use the cotton for something. Or should I? Is the cotton like actually useful for anything? Where's the nearest workshop? Okay, do you do anything from the cotton? Yeah, you actually can make cloth from the cotton. You just require two of those. Hmm. I think you could try to automate that process, like, a lot. If you think about that. And then I could try to automate the clothing production as well. That could actually be a nice thing to do. Maybe you should actually try to to build this thing somewhere. There's like a nice open space over here, so maybe over there. We have some herbs here that I could try to get rid of. I have a bunch of cash, so I can go a little bit crazy with construction if needed. You know what? Let's actually try to unlock this land. I want to see what's on the desk. Oh! What's this? An air temple! In the lake. Interesting. Alright, that's very nice. And what's in the desert? More resources. Okay, and this thing can, Penty can continue even more. Is there like an actual sea over here? Is this just like the limit of my kingdom that I can have? I have a bunch of gold, so let's try to unlock this thing. Yeah, apparently this is the limit? Interesting. But there's like a lot of flat ground over here. Maybe we could try to make the mining operations here. That'll be cool. Yeah, but then transferring all this thing to the main town is gonna be a problem. Yeah, I need to figure out a way, or a place actually, where I want to place my forges. Because we need to get into the Iron Age finally in this game. For now though, we're gonna focus on actually something different. So I want to make myself another farm over here, because at the moment those farms are requiring two workers to maintain the grain production to supply to two grain mills. So I'm gonna show you more or less how the entire like building of the automated grain production works like. I hope you get the idea. So let's see. Okay, so this one ends its farm over here. Let's actually level up this ground over here. Where is the leveling ground? Okay, up terrain, flatter up. There you go. Nicely done. Okay, and I want to make a fence over here. Because reasons, because I can. And I want to make this thing pretty. Now, I have a bunch of sugar here. So maybe I should try to make like a temporary barn and collect some sugar. Let's see, do I really need to? Because the sugar is used to make cakes, right? In the kitchen. Let's see. Yeah, you need sugar to actually make cakes. The thing is, I'm not planning at the moment to get cakes. Even though that the cakes are responsible to give you the final type of coin, currency. But still, that requires egg and a bunch of other things. And I didn't think out like a proper production of that thing. Later on, I want to have more houses, which means I'll need to have more grain anyway. So, yeah, I'm gonna get rid of those. And we're gonna make ourselves like... I need to have two additional farms over here anyway. So let's get rid of this. There you go. All of this thing needs to disappear. Lovely. Okay, probably these trees as well. So we're gonna have like a nice flattened area over here. Now, let's see. I need to flat this a little bit more. So, flatten up. Okay, so let's see. This thing goes here, right? So I'm gonna level this thing up here. Beautiful. Humanity. Progress. Alright, that thing goes. Now, I need to make a farm. What's the farm? Okay, there's a farm. I'm gonna probably try to build you on the same spot as this thing, right? So you have to go more or less here. Yeah, like this. Okay. Get rid of this bush, so by mistake you won't try to farm it. There we go. Okay, I also need to level this thing up. Tools and flatten the terrain up. Beautiful. Okay, still within range? Yeah. Okay, there's still ghosts over here, so we need to like level up this thing. We're gonna make it pretty, you know? I have this money and resources to actually use it for something. Right, nothing is to level up. Now, later on, I would like to have a world over here. So, we need to change this thing a little bit. I need to level this thing up a little tiny bit. So, get rid of this as such. Let's see, where are the roads? Okay, the roads are over here. So, the roads will be going like this, right? That means I need to have... let's see, where is the scaffolding? There it is. All right. Okay, you're gonna go up here. Remove this one. And probably remove this one because it's too low. So that means I have to now make this. And then two of those. Two of those and two of those. Okay. Now we need to make a bridge over here. 1, 2, 3. Beautiful. Now use the... Where is the paths? Aha. Cloth conveyor belt. Actually what? One second. Something like this. Okay, and I need to make sure that scaffold will go up one more. As such. Puffing. And continue this thing. There you go. Aha! Beautiful. Man, this is... It's like Factorio, but a little bit more relaxing, let's be honest over here. I mean, Factorio is constantly stressful. I mean, I love Factorio. Factorio is the game that actually I have the biggest challenge in, and I really love that game, but then again, if you want to relax and you just want to have fun, then yeah, you go for this game. Also, this is the computer blocks thing. You can actually make like entire logic things, just like in Factorio, but I haven't get into this thing yet, but I'm guessing like this is gonna be fancy. Bool function, agent trigger, logic lamp, logic set block, logic pusher block. There's a lot of things over here. Signal gate, timer block, delta block. Holy shit, man. I actually would like to see somebody who knows how to use those things, you know, because those are like great tools to make a really nice automated city in this game. Now, where is the... remove blocks, okay. I want to remove you. Okay, I have to just probably like do this, okay. I want to make a path of the road. So you're gonna be like nice and dandy, and you're gonna connect. I want to make this thing to look like an actual city, you know? I don't want this thing to just be floating blocks around. No, I want to actually turn this thing into something that could resemble a city one way or another, so... That's why the road is over here. Now the problem is gonna come because we need to add a new farm to the system, and I want to test out one thing that could possibly work. No, we're gonna see. So basically what I need to do, first things first, let's get the road over here. There we go, connect it nicely. Oh yes. Oh, it looks so cool. Man, I'm enjoying this thing way more than I should. Okay, so I made a grabber over here, so that means I can now rotate this farm as such. There you go, so actually it's gonna look like somebody is living here and this thing is just getting delivered automatically. So nobody's gonna complain. Get rid of those things. Finish off the road. As such. Beautiful. Okay, now I can make more farms. As such. Beautiful. Now remember to add the grains. There you go. Grain's gonna grow over here nicely. Very nice. Okay, we're gonna also have a usage of the animal fertilizer thingy. Okay, so that thing goes in. Now, the thing is that I'm not sure can I actually combine those things, but there's like a high chance that this thing will get blocked, right? So to prevent that thing from happening, we're gonna try to do something here. And by that, I mean, we're gonna build ourselves the silo. So the silo can get built over here. Okay, it gets resources automatically. Actually rotate this thing because the ladder is over here, so I want to make this thing look pretty. Now, this goes in, this goes out. Okay, now make a grabber. What's the grabber thingy? Logistic blocks, grabber, put it here. There you go. So the grabber grabs the resources from the silo and throws down the way over here. All those things goes into the barn sorts all the grains, and then moves those things inside of the grain mills, yeah. So that works. So that means if I'm gonna now grow something over here, then those resources should get automatically filtered out by the silo. I hope, we'll see. So let's make like a nice big field over here. Just remember to connect this thing with the road. Road just go here. Okay, let's move something like this. Beautiful. paving. Very nice. Oh, shit. My mistake, what the hell I'm doing? Wrong things. There you go. Now be sure, because we now need to make sure that those things will get splitted, right? So splitter here. And be sure to add, where are the paths? There you are. Conveyor belt. And then conveyor belts is gonna move over here. There you go. So now they're gonna split the fertilizers. The fertilizers will go to this farm. They're gonna fertilize the farms, the fields. And everything will be very nice. Very, very nice indeed. Just make sure that I'm gonna have a bunch of those. Beautiful. Okay, set recipe. Grain. Get me some grain. Apply. Beautiful. And now because the grain storage is rising, I can now remove one worker from each of the farms over here. There you go. So everything will get balanced out. And now I have two additional workers free. And they could try to put 10 different jump. I think I can also get rid of this one. Yeah, I think we should be fine. Yep! Because of this one farm, now I'm overflowing myself with grain. This is wonderful. I got so much grain right now that this barn is getting overfilled. I think I'll have to connect this thing to another kitchen. Oh no! Who would have guessed? I mean, to additional grain mills, because like this is overflowing. Oh my god, what I have done! I've destroyed my perfect balance. No, Thanos would not be proud, that's for sure. Oh no! Oh well. Yeah, that's like difficulty. How I can solve this thing? Okay, this one's getting like a nice amount of grain, so no point in adding more grain. If I'm gonna try to build two additional grain mills over here, then I could try to maybe deliver them to this kitchen over here. Yeah, that actually sounds like a solid plan, so maybe we're gonna try to do that thing in the future. We'll see. For now, not this. For now, I need to be sure that this kitchen will be connected to the rest of the network. By of conveyor belts, of course. Oh, a little bit too high. Okay, I cannot lower this thing. How can I actually do this? Hold on a second. If I'm gonna try to do something like this. Okay, and then try to go around. Would that be a good idea? Probably would be a terrible idea, but yeah, sure, let's try to do it anyway. So go here, here, around. Like this. That I think is gonna work, right? Should work. Should work. Let's see. Can I connect this thing? Yeah, okay, this is level up. Okay, this thing goes above. Something like this. Okay, now be sure to make a scaffold here. Is this even aligned? Yeah, it is. Beautiful. Okay. So now make sure to make a grabber here. What's the grabber thingy? Here? There you go. Ah! I can already taste the delicious meals the kitchen is making. Aha! Beautiful. Truly beautiful. Okay, so I think for now our problems with food and like getting money out of that thing should be solved. How's the research going? It's halfway there. Ugh, still far away. Okay, we need to figure out what else we should try to do to automate this entire process. The general store accepts like a bunch of interesting items. Maybe it's actually time to get into more of those productions. Yeah, that'll be cool. Now, since we're still like waiting for this thing to get finished, how about we're gonna add one more resource to the repertoire? For example, I need to deliver wheels here, right? So at the moment I'm making, I think, wheels somewhere here. Yeah, I'm making them here. And then I get to get transferred there by a cart. So basically, I thought that the forest is gonna cut out all of this forest here, but no! Apparently, once he cuts down a tree, he grows it. So this is like unlimited amount of trees for me, right? So we're gonna use that mechanic over here. Here, exactly. So I have like a little bit of space over here. We could try to use this thing to build like a forester or even two. Because I'm getting a lot of red coins from the meat that I have here. How much you gonna pay me for... Can I check somehow this thing? Like, what's the resource that you're gonna pay me for... Where's the workshop? There it is, okay. So, let's see. Okay, this thing is gonna give me gold coins. I need something that's related to wheel that's gonna give me red coins. Okay, tools gives me red coins. And actually a lot of them, if you think about that. The bandages also give me red coins. So maybe I could try to make like a cotton farm somewhere and then just transform those things into actual like bandages. Books don't give me anything. Clothing gives me 10 coins. Yeah, that's probably the thing I should try to focus on in the future. To actually automate the cloth production, okay? Because this is technically automated, but not fully automated. So that's like a thing we have to fix on in the future. I'm getting like tons of grain from this thing, so... putting like two additional grain mills over here would not be a problem. And I could have more of the animal feed, right? So then I could try to make maybe more pastures. Because right now, yeah, well, technically they are getting food, but not enough. If I would build two grain mills over here and order them to make flour and animal feed, and then use conveyor belts to transfer this thing here, and then when make one more grain mill to just focus on the animal feed, then I think this should be balanced out, right? So I'll be able to add maybe two additional pastures here. and get maybe some other resources. But that's gonna be the thing for the future. For now, let's try to get some wood. So, I got like a bunch of villagers over here that I could try to get rid of. So we're gonna free some workforce. Right, now, what do we need? We need to have the forester. So, the forester will be standing here. Okay, he's gonna be grabbing the logs. Yeah, he should be able to grab all of these things. So I can actually like put him like this. So he can later on get connected to a road to make it a little fancy. So that's this thing, okay? Now we need to make like a small workshop somewhere here. Probably on this hill here, next to the coal that later on would disappear. Yeah, that's like a thing. So, level up this ground. Terrain up. Something like this, right? Okay, that's actually quite nice. The road can go here if needed. Okay. So buildings, where is the forester? Can I get you actually like a little bit deeper into the forest? Yeah, I could try to build you here actually. That's not a bad idea. Remove resources. Remove those. Add the forester. Oh, beautiful. Alright, so you're gonna get me logs, right? There you go. Okay, you'll be getting logs. Hold on a minute, don't do anything yet. So you do logs, right? Let's actually make you like a temporary road here. Something like this. Beautiful, we're gonna have a road to the beach as well. Alright, so that's one thing. Now, I need to have like a small workshop area over here. So the logs will go around this thing to here. I think I should have to actually increase the hill of the forester so that the gravity will do the work for me. Yeah, because if I want to have a path here, then I need to do that actually. So that means I'll have to make... Let's see how big this thing needs to be to allow people to walk through. Like this. Give me like a worker over here. Get out here, man. Come on. Now, the actual workplace will be over here. I had to block the barns. so that the villagers won't try to drop other resources over here. Because that, like, messed up my plan completely. I tried to fix up this thing in the meantime. Yeah, like, right now, it looks like a complete mess. If you think about that. But also, this thing is getting crumpled even more. So, like, we have to... I have to, like, figure out what I could try to do here to... like make this thing more smooth. And I think I'm gonna make something I did like over here, because if you probably don't see this thing, but there are actually like two layers of conveyor belts, let's put it this way. So on the bottom there is the animal feed, right? That's getting produced by the grain mill. Okay, so that's the animal feed. The animal feed goes underneath this thing. All of this goes over here and then connects to the main conveyor belt that goes to the pastures over there, right? So this is this thing over here. Okay. I don't know why all of a sudden I got overflooded with flour, but that's okay. And speaking of flour, now we have those two things, right, with the grabber. The grabber is set to filter only flour. So he grabs flour, he puts it on this thing, and then this thing slides down here. Then you have a splitter over here, so it can actually get thrown over here if needed. If not, it then continues its journey towards the next kitchen, which is like down here. Then the kitchen makes the food, gets on the conveyor belt, goes around here, into the main one, and then goes to the village over there. So, yeah, like, that thing is working. It's just crumpled together, so... like, from one side, it looks... it's working, but it looks like... it looks shitty, let's be honest over here. I think I need to figure out maybe to use, like, different scaffolds or something over here, because it just looks too crumpled together. I mean, it's working, but... visually, nah, that's not gonna work, man. Okay, speaking of visuals, I need to increase the ground over here because it's gonna annoy me. I can't because I set this thing here. Okay, increase this thing here. Now, make a barn, and probably the second I'm gonna build that thing, the people will drop resources inside, so that's a bummer. Okay, don't drop resources inside, you morons. Ugh. Why you do this? Why you keep doing this thing? Alright, so those things are set, okay? Now, the general store is over here. So, I need to figure out how exactly I'm gonna transfer all of those resources over there. Yeah, we're gonna have to go around, that's for sure. Probably we have to go through those peach trees over here. Yeah, that's gonna be a difficulty, but okay, whatever. So, first things first. And this guy will make us logs, right? So we need to make sure that he'll be able to transfer those logs around. Also, wait, hold on a second. How do I make the wheels? Oh. Okay, that's a problem because this thing needs to make planks first. And then he can make the wheels. Okay, so how much does the plank cost you? Oh, wait, I need to have a sawmill, not a workshop. Hold on a second, I just screwed up something. Lumber mill. Yeah, we need this thing. So this thing needs to make planks as such. Then it goes to the barn. So we're gonna have like a stockpile of planks if needed for like further construction. So we got this thing. And then it has to go to the workshop. Okay, I did screw up this thing a little tiny bit. Good thing I found out before I connected everything. So tools. Okay, flatten the terrain. Make it like nice. As such. Okay. Now make me hold on a second. We need to have a workshop, right? So workshop will be here. Here? Yeah. It's not gonna look nice, that's the problem. Because those things will act as the buffer, the barns, okay? So I'm gonna have like a stockpile of resources if needed, like a backup resources or something like that. Okay. So the workshop is over here. I could try to maybe make like a bridge over here. Yeah, but then again, I have to go through here, right? The conveyor belt needs to go here. Next to this thing, around this peach tree forest over here. So I have to make this thing. I can make it actually like down here. That shouldn't be a problem. Let's see, where is the workshop? Okay, I need one more workshop. So the workshop will be built, let's say, here. Okay, that should work. So this workshop will be making us wheels. Okay. This thing, wait, planks? Oh wait, I don't need this thing. This is the thing I need. Wheels. Okay, so that means I just need a barn downstairs. Where's the barn? Barn. There it is, okay. So the barn will go here. Here? Wait, it goes around. It goes around, right? So one, two, here. Okay, now block everything. Wheels, where are the wheels? Shit. Okay, once again got resources inside. Okay, so that should work. Now, connect all of this thing. So, conveyor belt. Dude, can I like leave? There you go. Alright, so this thing grabs the logs from here, goes here, makes the planks. The planks then go to this barn to get stockpiled. Then they go to the workshop, they make into the wheels. And then they get transferred to the barn, which can hold up some wheels, you know, as a buffer. And then all of this thing needs to go here. So I need to now get rid of the resources. So tools and remove resources. Okay, so this is gonna be the path over here. Come on, get rid of it. Beautiful. Where are you going? Where the hell is this dude? What? Why are you dropping those things here? What in the hell is happening? Oh, I don't think I want to know. I just ignore it, man. Just avoid it, you know. You didn't save anything. Right, make a road here. Let's make it here. There you go. Beautiful. Okay, then out goes over here. Actually, I could try to make like some fences here, just to make it more pretty. Something like this. Oh, come on. Sometimes the roads are like so annoying. There you go. Beautiful. It's actually good I decided to build this thing over here because I just noticed that I ran out of planks. Oh no! That's gonna be a problem. Alright, grabber. Put a grabber over here. Alright, aha! It's already working. There we go. Okay, so the wood goes into the barn for like, you know, for as a buffer, just in case. Actually, I think I could try to make something smaller here. Like a silo? Can a silo actually hold the logs? No idea. So this thing goes into the lumber mill, then it goes into the barn. Why can I do anything? Ah, the game bugged. Ah, I had to restart it. So it should work now. Goes here, into the lumber mill, transforms into planks. The planks go into the barn. get moved to the workshop. The workshop then turns them into wheels. The wheels goes to the barn. And after that, you have to go out. So slowly and steady, wheels will be get delivered to the general store, which I need to finish over here. And it should actually work. Unbelievable, it actually is working, holy shit. And with this simple mechanic, the automation once again triumphs over the simple worker. Efficiency, ladies and gentlemen, it's all about efficiency. So, as once again, the forester cut down the trees. Basically, if needed, like if he's gonna cut down one tree, he is gonna automatically regrow that tree, because reasons. Then the logs get transferred over here into this barn over here that acts as a buffer. So just in case if I'm gonna have more logs that I can keep up with the production, and this thing could be stored over here for like a later use. It goes to the lumber mill, where it's get transferred into the planks. The planks are now moved by the grabber into the, by the grabber into the barn as a buffer once again, same deal. Then once again as a grabber over here into the workshop. The workshop then turns them into the wheels. The wheels go into the barn where they are stockpiled if needed, and then everything goes nicely by conveyor belt to the general store, and the people can enjoy it. And now my happiness is growing like crazy, which means that also the productivity increases. So therefore, because I have more happiness, I get more productivity for free. So that means my entire city makes more resources. So in the end, yeah, it's all about efficiency. I mean, like, look at all of those goods we're transferring here. So nice. So the people are receiving like a bunch of food from the kitchens we have over there. And now they're receiving also this thing, the gadgets, which are provided by the wooden wheels. So slowly and steady, we're gonna fulfill this thing very nicely. And did I finish the mining? No, I almost finished the mining. Okay, I'm gonna let this thing run for like a little tiny bit, so we're gonna see exactly how does the mining works for the future notice. Yes, I've built another forester over here because I kinda need to have logs in my main base, so that's like the thing necessary. Also, I have a bunch of wheels over here. Ha. Huh. I'm gonna keep them to make carts just in case, so I won't move those wheels from that thing. We also need to get rid of this forest over here because it's standing on the way of my road, soon to be road, and also I need to probably... I didn't want to, but I have to clear up this forest here so that we can squeeze in more houses. Also, the school will have to disappear from here because I don't think it actually adds any benefits to the city, like whatsoever. So that's gonna be another thing for the future noticed. Why this thing is not working? Oh, because we don't have logs. I mean planks. Well then, let's fix this thing, shall we? Automation, ladies and gentlemen. Where's the forester? There he is. Make me a forester over here. Move all of those guys. Actually, wait. I actually want to get rid of this forest anyway, so... get to work. Now! Honey got unlocked the mine. Took you a while. Goddammit, game. Okay, where's the mine? Can I... I cannot even build it because I don't have a free worker slot. Okay, one of you need to get sacrificed to dark gods. Thank you. Right, where's the mine? There it is. Can afford to bring more resources to base. What? Wait, what do you need for this thing? Oh, I need rail tiles? Oh. And then to get the machine shop for that thing. Okay. What do you need for this thing? You need iron, planks, stone bricks. Well, that's a difficulty. Who would have guessed? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so apparently I need to set up the production and we need to make ourselves some rails. That's interesting. Okay, good to know. So, alright, I'm gonna set this thing to work. Hopefully I'll be able to actually figure out how to get the mine to work. And after that, we're gonna try to, well, automate, I guess, the mine production and see how that's gonna go. For now, we've automated this thing, which works really great. It took me a while to actually build this thing, but still. We've managed to automate the wheel production. I've added myself one more forester because one forester is just not enough to maintain constant, like, production. So, two is a little bit of an overkill, but still, like, better than having one. Like, now we are having a constant flow of the wheels to the shop, so it's, like, progressing really, really well. Anything else? I don't think so. The only thing you could try to do, too, maybe is, like, add another person here. just to increase the productivity a little tiny bit. Yeah, but I am stockpiling slowly planks, so that was also like part of my plan. So yeah, it's progressing. We're gonna see if you guys have like a better idea of a layout for those things. Let me know in the comment section below, because for now, I'm gonna leave this thing as of here. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the flagged episode. This is absolute. I'll see you all in the next video.